Let's talk about radioactive iodine, also called RAI. These medications are just known by the generic name of radioactive iodine. There aren't any trade names. Let's look at the therapeutic use of RAI. This medication is used for hyperthyroidism or Graves' disease. Hyperthyroidism is when there is an overactive thyroid. RAI decreases the active cells of the thyroid. It also helps with the thyroid cancer, which is cancer of the thyroid, typically caused by a tumor. So, RAI works to destroy cancer cells. The action of RAI is physiological. Typically, a single dose is given and the patient excretes radioactive iodine through urine, tears, and sweat. They typically have to isolate themselves for an entire week because, like I said, they are secreting high levels of radioactive iodine within the first week. Then the medication helps to permanently damage or kill thyroid cells, which are responsible for an overactive thyroid or the thyroid cancer. Now we'll look at some of the must-know side effects. The first side effect is radiation sickness. Some symptoms of this include GI upset like nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, soreness around the neck because remember, that's where the thyroid lies, and symptoms that affect the mouth like dry mouth, altered taste, and swelling of the salivary. Another major side effect is bone marrow suppression. This is caused by the destruction of cells due to repeated or prolonged treatment. The damage to the white blood cells can increase the patient's risk for infection, and damage to the red blood cells can result in anemia. Hypothyroidism can also occur due to the destruction of cells in the thyroid. To remember the signs and symptoms of hypothyroidism, you can think of the memory trick, hypo, think everything is low. So we will see a decreased energy or fatigued, decrease in body temperature, these patients tend to be very cold, a decrease in metabolism, which can lead to weight gain, decrease in heart rate and blood pressure, and a decrease in blood sugar levels or hypoglycemia. Now let's look at some patient education. Thyroid replacement therapy may be needed following RAI if hypothyroidism occurs. Most commonly, this is levothyroxine tablets. Levothyroxine, think, elevates thyroid hormones. Remember, this patient is excreting radioactive iodine, so for at least 1 week after administration, the following should be implemented. You want to educate them, do not go in contact with crowds, children, and pregnant women. Any patient with a menstrual cycle must have a negative pregnancy test before starting this therapy. Do not sit near others for long periods of time, such as waiting rooms, planes, and concerts. Do not share food and drinks with others, and do not breastfeed. You also want to educate them to sleep in a separate bed, use a separate toilet and flush multiple times, use disposable cups, plates, and utensils, and wash laundry separately from others. Now let's review some of the most commonly tested on information regarding radioactive iodine therapy. This therapy is used to treat hyperthyroidism and thyroid cancer. Thyroid replacement therapy like levothyroxine may be needed if the patient develops hypothyroidism after treatment. Some major side effects are radiation sickness, bone marrow suppression, and hypothyroidism. The patient should isolate themselves from others at least 1 week following administration of RAI due to the increased radiation levels in the body. If you want more information like this, you can find it in the Complete Pharmacology Flashcards. It covers everything you need to know in your pharmacology class, but it's presented in a fun and condensed way, no more textbook fluff. That's all for radioactive iodine therapy. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Happy studying, future nurses.